So I was fascinated to read that you are sure that divine intervention inspired you to get this part.
Yes.
In what way?
What happened was that in 2007, which is the first time I actually read the script, I had only moved here 2 months prior. I hadn't done any Hollywood movies. I'm a British actor. So I read this script called Selma, and there's this role of Martin Luther King. And in July of that year, on the 24th of July, 07, I felt God tell me, you are going to play this role.
Did Oprah also have a part to do in this divine intervention as well?
Well, she
did
was,
she help she, that
she
along?
She was part of the divine intervention. I met her on the film The Butler, in which we played mother and son. And she just became an incredible friend of mine, a real advocate for me, a real mentor, someone I could go to. I showed her a tape of my audition tape for playing Dr. King, and she said, I can see it. It's not there yet, but I can see it.
It is unacceptable that they use their power to keep us voiceless.
Do you think that there is an advantage to not being an American-born actor? So did you bring a fresh perspective to that role?
100%. I know that. I mean, he's an incredible figure in this country's history, but I didn't grow up with that. So I was able to approach him as a man, as a character, and that's what we tried to do with the film. One thing I couldn't afford to do is do an impersonation of him. You have to show the spirit of the man. Of course, he had very specific accent, cadence, especially during the speeches. But what I tried to do is to do all of that work and then open myself up to his spirit.
Tell me, have you had a divine message that you're going to win an Oscar?
God stopped short of that, thankfully. No, I haven't had any divine messages to that end, but I wouldn't say no.
The film really looks amazing. Selma is now showing in New York, D.C., L.A., and Atlanta. It will open in 1,800 theaters on January 9th.